often said, all good things must come to an end, and unfortunately the same goes for the 27th Winter Universiade in Granada. We do, though, have some great highlights still to show. In our final trip to the mountains, we'll look in on men's slalom. Then it's the final men's hockey games, first the bronze matchup between Canada and the Czech Republic, then the gold medal game featuring Kazakhstan and Russia. Then to wrap up our time in Granada, we'll review the closing ceremony. Here on the final day of alpine skiing competition, it's the men's slalom up in the Sierra Nevada mountains. And as you can see, conditions extremely difficult as the clouds and snow have come in and visibility is virtually nil. Temperature of -6. So temperature-wise, we're good. But as you can see, just really difficult conditions in terms of visibility for these athletes. But nonetheless, they are ready to go. First up, this is Maxime Rizzo of France. He finished third in the French Nationals in slalom back in December. And there you see the time to beat. And at the interval, he's well ahead, about a second and a half. Also won three FIS races in France leading up to Universiade in slalom. And there's his time, over a second and a half ahead. So he will move right now into first place. Next up is Filip Mlinsek of Slovenia. Again, the conditions are so difficult. The poles he has there glowing in this very dark, cloudy, snowy day in the mountains. He's making his way very well down through these gates. Of course, this is a timed race between two different runs, so they will do this first one. Mlinsek not enough to beat Rizzo. He'll be just over half a second behind. So this first run will be added with their second run to give the total time, and then that will determine the winners. This is Ramon Zinhausern of Switzerland. He was sixth in the giant slalom 2 days ago and 22nd at a World Cup race at Kitzbühel in Austria back in January. He moves into first place here, 1.35 seconds ahead of Rizzo. Now we look at Matej Falat of Slovakia. He already has a bronze medal in these games from the Super Combined back earlier in competition. He's also 13th in the Super G, but did not finish in the giant slalom. Working his way quite well through these gates here. And his time, a little over 2 seconds behind that of Zinhausern. So he will be fourth after the first run. And there you take a look at the standings after the first run. Conditions now clearing up a little bit as we head into the second run. And here is Falat. He did compete in the slalom at the Sochi Olympics, but did not finish on his first run. This is his second Universiade. He was 9th in the slalom in Trentino, 29th in the downhill, and 24th in the Super G. At the interval, he is a little bit ahead of pace. As he works his way down through these gates, again, visibility much, much better now for these athletes. They have a better sense of where they're heading on this course. Robin Buffet, the time to beat right now from France. And Falat, 3/4 of a second ahead, moves temporarily into first place. Now it's the Slovenian Mlinsek. He's a rarity in that this is actually his 4th Universiade. He won a silver medal in Erzurum in Turkey back in 2011. He was 12th in Harbin in 2009 in the slalom, and then 16th most recently in 2013 in Trentino. Working very well through these tight gates. And as he heads his way now down towards the finish line, the time to beat and he's just behind. He'll move now into second place. 5/100s back, and you can see him there. He knows how close he was. Now Rizzo, second after the first run. The time of 49.24. So can he find a way to finish in first spot or get to first right now? Rizzo making his way quite well down through the gates. But there you see him just slip up, and he will miss the gate, much to his frustration, and he is out of the competition. Now the leader after the first run, Zenhausern of Switzerland. He was 19th in the slalom at the Sochi Olympics. Well ahead at the interval of Fallat's time. So if he can make sure to stay upright and get through all the gates, he should be able to ski away with a gold medal. 96 competitors from 27 countries in this competition, and Zenhausern is looking to be the best of the bunch, and he is. An outstanding time, 3.68 seconds ahead of Matej Fallat of Slovakia. Zenhausern crushes the field today. And there you take a look at the standings. Zenhausern will take gold. Fallat of Slovakia, the silver. And Filip Mlynsek of Slovenia will claim the bronze medal here in the men's slalom at the Sierra Nevada Mountains. Bronze medal men's hockey action from the Granada Sports Palace here at Winter Universiade, Canada, taking on the Czech Republic. The Czech Republic fell last night to Kazakhstan 2-1 in their semifinal, while Canada lost 3-2 to Russia in an epic shootout battle. Canadian fans there to support their team, and the Czechs make their way to the ice here as well in their red jerseys. Starting goaltender for the Czechs, it'll be Patrick Polivka. An 887 save percentage and a 1.40 goals against average. For Canada, from the University of Calgary, Chris Lazarek, a 920 save percentage and a 2.33 goals against average. Both of these teams were undefeated before losing in their semifinal games. They're going to both try to end this one with a victory. Early on, Canada with all the chances, a great play there. Right in to Craig McCallum, who cannot roof it past Polivka. And here, a little tip pass over Maxwell. The great move, Kevin King follows it up and bangs it home as Polivka made the great initial save. But as you can see, couldn't control the rebound. Steiner couldn't get there in time, and King able to tip that one in. Now Canada, another 2-on-1. Pass over to DePap, and that one just under the arm of Polivka and wide of the other post. Now Tyler Fiddler, he flips around Skvor and backhands that one, but Polivka equal to the task with the glove stop. Now it is Elgin Pierce, leaves it for Cody Fowley, and he rips that one home. 2-0 Canada. You see there, long wrister, but this is a good angle. Polivka didn't really see it until the last minute when it was by him. There's a huge hit by Peschlar on Cody Curran, who actually left the game with a knee injury and didn't return. Late in the first period, 2-0 still Canada. Great chance there for Jan Mueller, but Chris Lazarek stretches out that right pad to keep it 2-0 after the first frame. Now in the second period. Puck here gets moved ahead to Milan Volashek, and he'll fire a wrister that beats Lazarek over his right shoulder, and suddenly the Czechs are right back into this thing, 2-1. There's a good look at it. Just knuckles over top of Lazarek's shoulder. And the Czechs feeling like they've got a bit of momentum here. Now Canada, Kevin King with the wrister. That one stopped by Polivka. There's head coach Dave Adolph of Team Canada. Now the Czechs on the power play. This one just tipped in front wide of the near post. and it remains 2-1 heading into the third period. Now Canada on the power play, but it'll be the Czechs that cash in. Daniel Arnost, as the puck tips off the stick of Jordan Rowley and up and over Lazarek. You can see there just that little deflection. Lazarek had no chance as it deflects right over his glove. And the shorthanded marker evens things up at 2. Canada though on the power play now. Jesse Craig with the pass over to McCallum, and he fans on it. A little bit further into the third period. Matt Delahaye with the shot, and it's tipped right in front. Beautiful play by Chris Collins. Gets his fourth of the tournament. And there you see the nice tip by Collins, and Canada back up 3-2. About 40 seconds later, Collins again tips it in front, and Mitch Maxwell, the beneficiary. Dominic Steiner could not get a control of the puck. And it's Maxwell able to swoop in and pop that one home. Quickly, Canada up 4-2. Here's Tyler Fiddler. That one gets deflected away. And Chris Collins now right in front. The great toe drag, but he can't beat the goalpost. You can see it there. Pavlovka sprawled out, but the post bails him out. Now it's Manning, beautiful little pass over to Chris Collins, who gets his second of the afternoon. And Canada up 5-2. Collins left all alone at the side of Pavlovka. Czechs now on the power play, but they pull their goaltender, and Kevin King will out-muscle Czech captain Dominic Steiner, and he'll wheel and fire that one into the empty net. Canada now up 6-2. Great effort there by Kevin King. And as the seconds tick down, Team Canada will skate away with a 6-2 victory and a bronze medal. Their 14th medal in 15 hockey appearances at Universiade, 9 medals in the last 10 years. We've reached the end, and now it's the gold medal game in men's hockey between Kazakhstan and Russia. Kazakhstan got here after a 2-1 victory in their semifinal matchup against the Czech Republic, while Russia defeated defending champions Canada 3-2 in a great shootout matchup in the semifinal. Kazakhstan are the defending silver medalists and Russia the defending bronze medalists. In goal for Kazakhstan, it'll be Mikhail Shmolnikov. He made 40 saves in the win over the Czech Republic. There you see head coach Sergei Starigin. And for Russia in goal, Sergei Belov, 37 wins in the victory over the Canadians. He's only allowed 2 goals in the whole tournament. There you see the Russian women's team, gold medal winners themselves, here to cheer on the Russian men's squad. And early into this contest, Timur Shingarev, he'll walk out from the corner and fire that one past Shmolnikov. And early on, the Russians have a 1-0 lead. Kazakhstan now on a power play. It'll be Ziatkov from Kukulin, but he bangs that one off the side of the net. Partial breakaway here for Kravchenko, but that one fired up and over the goal. Now it'll be Fedorov who picks the puck up, moves it ahead to Klimchuk. He'll fire it. Stopped by Shmolnikov, but the rebound goes right to Igor Kravchenko, and he'll fire it home. 2-0, Russia ahead. You see that big rebound by Shmolnikov, and he couldn't quite get over in time to close the 5-hole. Now it's Rafikov with a great chance, and then he tries to wrap around right through the crease. Shmolnikov with a great first save, and then the puck goes right underneath him through the crease, but not in. Now to the second period. Here's Kukulin with the chance, but that one's deflected over top of the Russian net. Then Safin knocks the puck down. He has a chance, but Belov covers up the rebound. You see a good replay of it there. Next, here's Vologodsky. He has a chance, also denied by Belov. Now midway through the second period, Alexander Torchyanyuk upstairs over Smolnikov with the assist from Barbashev. Beautiful shot there by the Russian captain, no chance for Smolnikov. Now Fedosenko, he rips one just wide of the net. Kazakhstan again on the power play, that chance there denied by Belov. There's another chance, blockered away by the Russian keeper who's just been outstanding in this tournament. Then a turnover by Kazakhstan and Aleshin. He's able to walk right in front, but denied by Smolnikov. Now in the third, still 3-0 Russia. Shot there from Vixna. And Kazakhstan, seconds later, will get on the board. Renat Safin, his second of the tournament. Yelikov leaves it there in front, and Safin able to bang it home. Belov, no chance. He thought Yelikov was going to hang on to the puck. Now Lebedev with a one-timer. That one goes off iron, as you'll see right there. Next is Oleg Lee, who set up in a great stop there by Smolnikov. Kazakhstan fans hopeful they can still get back into this one. Russia on the power play. Here's Kravchenko with a shot that goes just wide. Did not miss by much on that one. And then Russia with just over 4 minutes to go. It'll be Aleshin in front with the backhand. It too goes just wide. Under 3 minutes. Time ticking down for Kazakhstan, and a great chance there just off the outside of the post. Ziatkov, they thought it was in here, but the official waves it off. The puck never crossed the line. And the seconds tick down. The Russians have won the gold medal, defeating Kazakhstan 3-1. Sergei Belov ends up only giving up 3 goals the whole tournament. Artem Fedorov with 9 points to lead them in scoring. That's now 5 gold as the USSR and 6 as Russia. The last 7 gold medals have been split between Canada and Russia. Russia with 5, the Canadians with 2. The Russian fans very ecstatic as they win both men's and women's gold medals. Kazakhstan will take the silver and Canada will take the bronze medal. The Granada Sports Palace, the home for men's and women's ice hockey competition, now the home for the closing ceremony of the 27th Winter Universiade. First up to speak, the mayor of Granada, Jose Torres Hurtado. And there you see some of the athletes. The Kazakh athletes, of course, they will play host to the next Winter Universiade in 2017. Claude-Louis Gallien bringing closing comments on behalf of FISU. He is the president of FISU, first elected in 2011, as he replaced then-president George Killian of the United States. As is common in closing ceremonies, the lowering of the FISU flag as the FISU anthem Guariamus Igitur plays in the background. And this flag will be transferred from Granada to Almaty, Kazakhstan, the next host of the Winter University Games. Those will take place from January 29th to February 8th, 2017. First, you'll see members of the Granada Organizing Committee, as is tradition, wave the flag. These games of 2015 split between Granada as well as Slovakia. 1,551 total athletes from 43 countries. As the flag is passed through the members of the Granada organizing team, and there you see Mayor Jose Torres Hurtado. And Claude-Louis Gallien will then hand it off to the Almaty organizers. The organizing team is led by Ilya Razakov. And Almaty translates literally into rich in apples. Apples have grown since ancient times in Almaty. Almaty is the largest city in Kazakhstan, 1.6 million people. It's the largest city, though Astana is the capital. Now words on behalf of the organizing committee. Almaty is in southern Kazakhstan, near the Kyrgyzstan border. Average temperature in February, -3 degrees Celsius. So if that type of weather can hold up, it will be a great games in 2017. There you see again the Kazakh athletes, some of whom will likely participate in their home nation. And then the flame will be extinguished as a symbol of the closing of these games of Granada. And then the flags of the 43 countries that did participate here. Russia led the medal table, 20 gold, 18 silver, 18 bronze for 56 medals. Korea was second with 5 gold, 9 silver, 2 bronze for 16 total medals. Kazakhstan was third, 5 gold, 6 silver, no bronze for 11 total. Host Spain, no gold, 2 silver, 0 bronze for a total of 2. And that will conclude the coverage of the 27th Winter Universiade from Granada, Spain. Incredible athletes, incredible competition, and an incredible time here in Granada. We look forward to seeing you at the 2017 Winter Games in Almaty, Kazakhstan.
Education meets sport and culture. What best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? Which event gathers the best student athletes from around the world? The Universiade, the home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.